Hey everyone, welcome back. In this Selenium with Java tutorial series, I'm starting the Selenium with Java framework, and the first project that we'll be starting with is the hybrid framework. And in this framework, I will be basically covering all the concepts and the details that you would need to implement any sort of hybrid framework into your project. Now, when we say hybrid framework, we'll be using the capabilities of data-driven and then do the best practices or how you are going to structure your code overall and then ensure that the test automation that you are trying to do is maintainable, robust, breaks less, and gives you the maximum return on investment for the efforts that you made within the team. So when we talk about framework, I have created a detailed video on what exactly the test automation framework is all about in my Selenium with Python tutorial series. I'll post a video so that you can watch that, because that's very important interview question and you will get a lot of detail about the framework in general. What exactly is test automation framework? So watch that and then come to this particular video. Now, this is the advanced section of this whole series. So if you haven't watched 100 plus videos that I have posted before for the Selenium automation, please go ahead and watch it. It's all available on YouTube channel for free. So you can go ahead and watch before you can jump into the framework section. I can assure you this is very, very exciting journey, and you will be able to design the framework hands-on, understand each and every aspect. I will try to simplify as much as I can so that even if you are absolute beginner to the automation, you should be able to pick all the concepts. So I'll try to correlate with the real life examples as much as I can, right? So first thing is the project structure. So when we talk about framework, briefly, what exactly is framework? So if in general, usually if you just go for a definition of framework, it's just a supporting structure to anything. A car has a framework, which is a structure on which the car is being supported. When you build a house, there is a framework that is being built of the steel and metal and pillars that support the overall structure, wherein you build the house, and then that's how the more functionalities are being added to that. So the core structure of any building, any object, is what the framework is. Now, same is true for the programming language. When we say about the test automation framework, it's the supporting structure that will help you to build your test cases or write your test cases more efficiently, manage them efficiently, debug them efficiently, and a lot more advanced functionalities and better functionalities, basically. So it will make your life easier, to be very simple, right? To make it things simple. So when we say a framework or structure that we are going to build initially, so we'll be using Maven, so which is build and dependency management tool. Absolutely necessary to know about Maven if you are starting your automation journey. So in Maven, what we'll do is we'll create a difference or the base structure to start with. So for example, the base module, you can say, or base package, which will contain the base class, which will have all the key details or all the important common methods that can be utilized within the framework. Then you have the utilities. Say, for example, some common method that will be utilized by all other test cases, which doesn't usually require the driver reference. We'll move it to the utilities. So both of these base and utilities, you would find that these are basically, these will be holding something which can be utilized again and again, so that your duplication is less. In the base class, we'll be having something which is more of a driver, web driver related reference, and in the utilities, it will be more of the common utils that do not require driver reference directly as such. Okay. Then in the test cases, pretty straightforward, we'll be keeping our test cases. So just understand these as the folders that we'll be creating in the Maven project or in the Eclipse. I'll go on that bit in a moment, but just understand that this is the structure that we'll be building. In the config file, so we'll be doing the configuration, right? So rather than having all the details into our test case, we need to externalize. So what config files can hold is, say for example, I want to specify a browser on which I want to run my test case. So in the config file, I can specify browser is equal to Chrome, and depending on the details that are being passed from the config file or from the external user input, I can basically then, or my script can read those details and run the test cases, similar with the test URL. So there are multiple test in your test environment in a project. So in the config file, we can maintain all of those details so that we do not need to go into our script and change those details. If I have 100 scripts, I can't go and update the locators or update the URL endpoints, etc. in those scripts. It's always advisable to externalize those hard-coded details at one place so that you can manage those easily. So that's what we'll maintain in the config files. Then in the test data is what we'll be maintaining the test data in. So for example, when we write a test case, there will be a data requirement. So for example, user registration. So user registration will have first name, last name, etc. So all of that detail or the data, instead of hard coding into the test cases, I will externalize it into the test data Excel file or CSV file. And there are different ways that we have already covered in those previous videos of Selenium with Java that you can go ahead and watch how to read through those files. But even if you haven't watched those, I'll still be covering lot many details in this series as well. But it's always advisable to have hands-on with all those concepts first before coming to the advanced Selenium framework section. Then logs is what we'll be using log4j to have the logs into the log file so that if there is any debugging that you are doing, you can go ahead and see the logs where your script failed basically, right? Then reports will have the reports, test reports that you need to send to your stakeholder. So this is the base structure, and then we'll quickly create the base structure in a project. And then we'll add the dependencies. So let's quickly go ahead to Eclipse and start creating our base structure. Okay, so to start with, now this installation of Eclipse, Java, Maven, everything has been covered. So I'll post the link of the videos so that you are up to this point, so that you have the Eclipse, everything has been ready for you. So now let me switch the workspace. So I'll create a new workspace basically so that we start fresh. So we'll simply browse, and here let me go back in Java, in Eclipse Learning, let me create a new folder and I will name it as Automation Framework. Okay, so this is the workspace, or basically you can say the folder where all my framework code that I'll be writing will be here. And now this is where we'll be creating our Maven project, and we'll create this project structure that we have discussed. Okay, all right, so it has opened, and we'll close this welcome window here. All right, now we have complete fresh space here with no old projects that we have already been working with. So now let's go ahead and click on file. So usually if you are already working in Eclipse and this is not the first or the fresh workspace, so basically you could go to the new and go to the project, because we will be creating the Maven project, right? So here, go to the Maven project, click on next and select create a simple project and click next. And now here provide the group ID. So group ID is something, say for example, you're working for IBM. So it's something like com.ibm. And then in the artifact ID, it's your basically the project. So for example, test automation project, right? So here I'll simply say com.stm, software testing mentor. And in the artifact ID, I will say test automation framework. All right. And click finish. If you want to get more details about the naming conventions, for example, group ID, artifact ID, and version, this is the official documentation. So group ID uniquely identifies your project across all projects. And that's the whole point. So for example, org.apache.maven, that's how the group ID should be. And then artifact ID is something, for example, specific project ID, right? So commons-math, or then the version is, if you are distributing different versions, so you can specify the versions, right? So here we are not, you know, we are just leaving it as default here and just putting the artifact ID and group ID and click finish. So now it will create the project. So in the right hand side, let me move this side. You will see that here in the right hand side, it will build the project. So you have to wait for it. And once the project has been built, you will see that you have this SRC main Java resources, test Java, SRC test Java and test resources. So this structure gets created automatically for you with Maven, right? So because Maven is build and dependency management tool, so it helps you to manage the dependencies and it gives you a good structure of the project already, which you can utilize in your test automation framework. Now, the another advantage of Maven is that we will be using Maven to build our test case. cases as well, right? So a lot of advantages there, but in very simple terms, you just need to understand that Maven is build and dependency management tool that we'll be using to manage all the dependencies, right? So using pom.xml, we can specify dependencies. And what are dependencies? So when you start developing automation framework using Selenium, so you need Selenium library so that you can write the test cases which are being understood, right? So library contains the classes and methods that you can use to write the test cases, which will actually open the browser. Then they will you will be able to send keys to the browser and drive the browser, right? Then for reporting, you will have another library. So there are so many libraries that we have already noted here. So these are the dependencies or libraries that we'll be by default starting with. As we go along with the course, I'll be adding more libraries. I do not want to confuse you in the initial step itself, but these are some of the libraries that we'll be adding. So first thing first, let's quickly create the project structure or the framework structure that we'll be utilizing. Okay, so the base is the base folder or base package, right? Now usually you see src main java, src main resources, and test java and test resources. So why main and test? So usually Maven is widely used by the developers as well. So when developers do their development work, all the code or the development code usually goes into the main java, and then anything resource related goes into the resources. Then any unit testing code goes into the test Java, and the resources, testing resources, go into the testing resources. Now we are using Maven for Selenium automation, so we'll be utilizing test Java and test resources, right? So when we say test Java, we are basically writing the test case for any application, right? So we will create the structure here. Now within this particular folder or the package that you see, src test java, will create the new packages, right? So let's quickly create the structure. So we'll say base, right? So sorry, lowercase. So base is what we'll be creating. And then we had utils, test cases, config, test data, logs, and reports, right? So where does the utils or the test data need to go, right? So usually anything resources or anything test related detail, the external files that you want to refer, goes into the resources. So we'll simply say that resources contains test data. So it's basically logical structuring. There is no hard and fast rule that this is how you are going to do, but logically it makes sense, right? In test Java, you have your test cases, you have the base classes, etc., right? So we'll have the test cases here as well. Okay, so we'll say test cases, and then we'll be having the utilities, right? So anything config file, test data, logs, reports will go into the resources, right? So we'll have utilities here as well, logs, reports, and what else? So we have logs, reports, test data, config files, base utilities, test cases, right? So config files will go into resources as well, right? So now you can see we have created the very basic structure, whatever we have said, that this is the project structure, right? So our test cases will be stored in the test case package here. The base package will contain all the, or basically the base class or the base driver, whatever we want to mention it there. So basically base Java class, which will contain all the details or the important methods that will be utilized by the test cases. In the utilities, we'll store all the utilities, right? Or the utils that will be the Java classes, which will be utilized, or which will be having the common utils that will be utilized by the test cases. In the config file, we'll store any of the properties file. In the logs, all the logs will be stored. In reports, all the reports will be stored. And the test data will be having the CSV or Excel file to have the test data there. You can store test data in any format. So if you are storing data into the XML format, you can store all of that test data here, right? So this is the very basic structure. So go ahead and prepare this, be ready, so that we can go ahead and in the next tutorial, we get started with adding these dependencies and start writing our first test case to progress with the test automation or Selenium with Java test automation framework. So that's all for this tutorial. I hope it was helpful. Thank you very much for watching.